Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. Today we are going to discuss solution of system of linear equations by inverting the coefficient matrix. By inverting the coefficient matrix mean inverse matrix. And this is the first lecture of 7th week for the course General Mathematics and Statistics. The system in matrix form, we get Ax is equal to b, where A is the matrix of coefficients, x is the coefficient, x is the matrix of unknown, and b is the matrix of constant. Then here today we are going to find the solution of system of linear equation by using the inverse matrix. So the inverse, by using the inverse matrix mean, first of all, multiplying the inverse of the matrix A from the left if matrix A is invertible, then we obtain A inverse into A into X is equal to A inverse into B. And since from the definition of multiplicative inverse of matrix A, we know that A inverse A is equal to identity. So identity dot X is equal to A inverse dot B. Identity matrix multiplied X matrix is equal to A inverse multiplied B matrix. And this is equal to X is equal to A inverse B. And this matrix X is the solution of given linear equation. Dear students, note that here to find the inverse of the coefficient matrix A, we can use any method like Cramer method or elementary matrix method. And these two methods have discussed in the last lecture. Now, for example, we have a system of linear equation 2x minus 3y is equal to 19, and the second equation is x plus 4y is equal to minus 7. So to find the solution of this system of linear equation, first of all, write this system in equation form as, for example, to write this system of equation in the matrix form is Ax is equal to b, where A is equal to, this is A matrix is the coefficient matrix, and the coefficient matrix is 2 minus 3 1 4, and X is the matrix of variable. There are two unknown variable X and Y, and this is equal to matrix of the constant. The constant matrix is 19 minus 7. So, dear students, note that first of all, in the first step, write the given system in the matrix form. In the matrix form mean Ax is equal to b. The coefficients of variables in this system are 2, minus 3, and 1, and 4. So A represent the coefficient matrix, and capital X represent the matrix of variable which are unknown, X and Y. And this matrix B represent the matrix of constant which are on the right hand side. So matrix B is 19 minus 7. Now, in the second step, find the inverse of the matrix. Since, dear students, in this system we have a 2 by 2 matrix, so the inverse of 2 by 2 matrix can be easily find by using the formula 1 over determinant of the matrix and adjoint of the matrix. So the determinant of the given matrix is 8 minus into minus 3, and for the adjoint of the matrix, change the sign and change the places. Change the sign of this diagonal and change the sign of this diagonal and change the position of this diagonal. So we obtain the adjoint of the matrix is 4, 3, minus 1, 2. And now 1 over determinant and adjoint of the matrix multiplied the determinant 1 over determinant into the adjoint of the matrix. We obtain the inverse of the matrix 4 by 11, 3 by 11, minus 1 over 11 and 2 by 11. Now and step 3, multiplying the matrix of constant which is B by A inverse on the left side. So we obtain X is equal to A inverse B. So this is the inverse of the matrix and this is the matrix B. Now multiplying these two matrices, we obtain after simplification 5 and minus 3. So the result for X is 5 and for Y is minus 3. Now dear students, we can check the solution for the given system. So to check the result, 2 and 2 X, this is the value of X, minus 3 and 2 Y. Since in the previous slide you see here, this is the value of Y. The value of Y is minus 3 and the value of X is 5. So 2X, 2 into 5 minus 3 into the value of Y, Y minus 3 is equal to 10 plus 9. 2, 5 the 10 and 3, 3 the 9. So 10 plus 9 is equal to 19, and 19 is on the right hand side of the equation number 1. This is equation number 1. So first equation is satisfied by the results. So now to check the results for the second equation, X plus 4 into Y, this is the value of Y. So 5 plus 4 into minus 3, so 5 minus 12 is equal to minus 7. And the right hand side of second equation we have minus 7. So the result is correct. Now let's move on another example. Suppose we have a system of equations and there are two equations, 2x plus 3y is equal to 11 and x plus 2y is equal to 6. To find the solution of this system by using the inverse matrix, first of all write this system in equation form as 2, 3, 1 and 2. This is the coefficient matrix and the variable matrix is X and Y, and the variable matrix has the variable X and Y, and the constant matrix obtained the elements 6, 11 and 6. Now in the second step, find the determinant and inverse of the matrix. First of all, find the determinant of the matrix. So since this is the coefficient matrix, so the determinant of this matrix is 2 to the 4 and 3 1 the 3. So 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. So this is the determinant of the matrix, of the coefficient matrix. And now to find the inverse of the coefficient matrix, so using the formula 1 over determinant and adjoint. For the adjoint, change the position of these two elements, change the places of these two elements. This red color highlight that, change the places of this diagonal, change the places of this diagonal. And this blue color represent that, change the sign of this diagonal. So change the places of these two and change the sign of these two. We obtain the adjoint is 2, minus 3, minus 1 and 2. Now 1 over determinant into adjoint of the matrix A. So we obtain the inverse of the matrix, of the coefficient matrix, 2, minus 3, minus 1 and 2. Now in the second step, to find the solution of the system by using this formula, X is equal to A inverse B. This is the variable matrix. In the variable matrix we have two variable X and Y, and inverse matrix of A multiplied B. So this is the inverse of the matrix, of the coefficient matrix, and this is matrix B. Matrix B is the constant matrix of constant. Constant lies on the right hand side of the equations. So matrix B have the entries 11 and 6. Now multiplying these two matrices, we obtain the solution of the system 4 and 1. So the value of x is 4 and the value of y is 1. Now to check to find the solution of this system and check your result, this is the example number 4. Since in this system we have the coefficient matrix 5 3 3 2, and the determinant of this matrix is a 2 5 the 10 and 3 3 the 9. So 10 minus 9 is equal to 1. So this is the determinant, and to find the inverse, one more determinant and adjoint of the matrix, change the place of these two of this diagonal and change the sign of this diagonal, we obtain adjoint of 2 by 2 matrix easily. So this is the adjoint of this matrix. Now for the inverse, using the inverse formula, 1 over determinant adjoint of A. So the determinant is 1 and this is the adjoint of the given coefficient matrix A. Now for the solution, using the formula x is equal to A inverse B. So in this system we have two unknown A and B. So this is in the variable matrix, we have two variables which are unknown A and B, and A inverse into B. This is the inverse of the coefficient matrix and this is matrix B. Matrix B contain the constant which lies on the right hand sides of the equation and system. So multiplying these two matrices, we obtain minus 1 and 4. So in this system the value of A is minus 1 and the value of B is 4. So now to check the result, putting these value of A and B in the given system, we obtain, this is equation number 1, 5A plus 3B is equal to 7. So 5 into A, this is the value of A, plus 3 into B, this is the value of B. In the right hand side of this equation, we obtain 7. So minus 5 plus 12 is equal to 7. So the result is true for the first equation. Now to check the result for the second equation, in the second equation we have 3a plus 2b is equal to 5. So 3 into minus a, this is the value of a, minus 1, plus 2b, this is the value of b, is equal to 5. In the right hand side, in the second equation we have 5. So minus 3 plus 8 is equal to 5. So the result is correct for second equation also. Now let's move example number 5. Determine whether the system has a unique solution. This is a system of two equations. To check whether this system has a unique solution, so first of all write the system in the matrix form. So in the matrix form we obtain the coefficient matrix which contain the elements 1 2 and 2 4. In the first equation we have the coefficient 1 and 2, and in the second equation we obtain the coefficient 2 and 4. So the coefficient matrix obtain the elements 1 2 and 2 4. First of all find the determinant of the matrix 4 1 the 4, multiplying these two entry and then multiplying these two, 4 1 the 4 and 2 to the 4, this determinant is equal to 0. So dear students, note that if in a system the determinant of the coefficient matrix is 0, then the coefficient matrix has no inverse, so the system does not have a unique solution. The system may be have no solution or have infinite many solution, but in this system, since the determinant of the coefficient matrix is 0, so we cannot find the inverse of the matrix, so the system does not have a unique solution. Does not have a unique solution mean that maybe the system has no solution or has infinite many solution. Since in the last lecture, in the previous lecture, we have discussed that a non-homogeneous linear system has three possibilities, has three cases for its solution. Maybe the system has a unique solution, maybe the system has no solution, maybe the system has infinite many solution. So when the determinant of the coefficient matrix is zero, it does not mean that the system has no solution. The determinant of the coefficient matrix is equal to zero means that in this system we cannot find the inverse for the coefficient matrix. So the system does not have a unique solution here. Maybe the system has no solution, or maybe the system has infinite many solution. It does not mean only that the system has no solution. The system does not have a unique solution in case of when determinant is equal to zero. But in this case, dear students, note that when determinant is equal to zero, then the system does not have a unique solution. Maybe the system has no solution, or maybe infinite many solution. Now let's move in another example, number 6. In this system we have three equation. First of all, write the system in the matrix form. This is the coefficient matrix. In this system we have the coefficient 1 minus 1 and 1, 1 minus 2 and minus 1, 2 minus 1 and 2. In the variable matrix have three unknown, x, y and z. And the constant matrix have three entries, 0, 5 and 8. So ax is equal to b. You can write simply ax is equal to b. So after ax is equal to b, we can write x is equal to a inverse b. So first of all, find the determinant for the coefficient matrix. If the determinant of the coefficient matrix does not equal to 0, then find the inverse of the matrix, and then multiplying the inverse of the matrix to the constant matrix, we get the solution of this system. And this is the home task for you. Now dear students, when we solve a system of non-homogeneous equation, non-homogeneous linear equation, by inverting the coefficient matrix by using the inverse matrix, so some points should be noted. If the coefficient determinant is zero, as I have already told you in the previous slide, if the coefficient determinant is zero, then it's mean that the system of equation has no unique solution. The system of equation has no unique solution. At this point is very clear from this sentence that the system of equation has no unique solution. It does not mean that the system has no solution. Simple, it is clear that the system of equation has no unique solution. Maybe the system has no solution at all, or an infinite solution. And the coefficient matrix of the system must be square. So the inverse matrix method can be used for that system in which the number of equations is equal to the number of unknown. Then we obtain the coefficient matrix like a square matrix. And this is the end of this segment. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.